Guys, this was probably the craziest week in AI, maybe ever. I really mean that. And I'm going to tell you what happened and what it all means, but the speed of it was head spinning. And listen, that's why when I go out and I train companies and they're like, where do you think this is all going to be in 2 years? I'm like, dude, I don't know where it's going to be like in 2 weeks. And this week it felt more like, where is it going to be in 2 hours? And I'm not even joking. So let's dive into this. As we do, just remember, would love if you subscribe to this channel. Also, come find me at ConnorGrennan.com because holy cow, we have this new amazing AI Mindset newsletter, the planet's best generative AI quick start guide. It's phenomenal. I'll send you a link. All right, this week. First of all, this week started out with huge news from OpenAI that ChatGPT was in essence getting a memory, right? And this is huge news because more than custom instructions and everything else, ChatGPT will actually start remembering you and your preferences across chats. Now that's huge because usually each chat, you know, on the left-hand side is like its own like cryogenically frozen brain. Like you could leave it there and you can come back to it and it'll remember everything. But then if you move to a new chat, it's like 50 first dates, it's like total amnesia, which was always a little bit frustrating. That is all changing. So what does this mean that it's getting a memory? Well, it's going to retain information about you, the user, sort of over time, like your coding preferences and your personal details and your past interactions. And that is huge. It's going to make conversations more personal, more efficient. It cuts down on all that time you needed to sort of keep reminding and repeating yourself in sort of like all these future interactions. So that's huge. By the way, OpenAI also sort of made note that, oh, they're going to put in like robust privacy controls. They've been pretty good about that and everything. So you can have it forget specific details, things like that, which actually I love because sometimes you're like, oh, I'm not really that person anymore. Anyway, I thought, that's the news of the week. Here we are. Like news won't get any bigger than this week. And I'm thinking maybe I should make a video about this. Well, like 24 hours later or 48 hours later or whatever, Google comes busting in like the Kool-Aid man. And it's like in this, by the way, very un-Google way. It's like, hey, we have a new product. And it wasn't sort of like really announcing it with giant fanfare. Like we're going to announce an announcement about it, which is what Google often did. So this is what it was. It was Gemini 1.5. Now, the cool thing about that was that 1.0 was only like 2 months ago. It was December. That's the one we'd all been waiting for, by the way. But 1.5 is meant to be on par with Gemini Ultra, which was their super duper model, which felt like, oh, that's like their super high-end thing. So that felt like serious news. But the big wow factor was that the context window, how much stuff you can put in there, is colossal. It's a million tokens, which is as big as it sounds. Compare that to ChatGPT-4, which has 128 tokens, and Gemini Pro, which was 32 tokens before that. And Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google, was like, guess what you can fit in there? How about the whole trilogy to Lord of the Rings? I don't know who's putting that in there, but still. By the way, the real big question is it going to remember all of that very well? I don't know. I don't have a huge amount of confidence. Anyway, forget that for a second. You know, we're going to all try it out when it comes out. But Google was feeling pretty proud of itself. And even though, you know, I'm pretty skeptical of Google these days because their demos have been like a little bit, you know, lie-ish, if you know what I mean. But still, I'm like, you know what? Maybe Google's making a comeback. And before I could finish the word comeback, OpenAI drops Sora and the internet cracks in half. So Sora is OpenAI's text to video, image to video with videos up to 60 seconds. And you know how like we've been blown away by like Runway Gen 2, Pika, stuff like this? Okay, this is way different. This single prompt, and they show the prompts, has this absolutely stunning realistic scene. Multiple people doing multiple different things in this hyper realistic way. And I'm not just talking about sort of animation, which tends to be a little easier. This is like Mid-Journey quality faces and images, except moving for 60 seconds. We're talking multiple characters, specific types of motion. levels of detail in the subject and in the background. It's been absolutely unbelievable. It has to be seen to be believed. It's not widely available yet. They're still red teaming it yet. Still, they're being super, super cautious about it. But it is out there enough that Sam Altman felt comfortable showing it off. And by the way, I kind of think that Google, like OpenAI, was just waiting and kind of punking Google a little bit. Like they were just like waiting for Google to sort of like shoot their shot. And then they would come in and like dunk over them 2 hours later. It's just too much of a coincidence. Anyway, guys, honestly, I don't usually say this is the most insane week in AI history. I think it actually genuinely was. I've never seen anything like it. So go on LinkedIn, go check this stuff out. Come over to ConnorGrennan.com. You'll find my whole AI mindset framework and everything over there. Can't wait to see you next time.